experienced impossible rescue and amazing protection. People who have received messages of love and comfort from beyond. People who have died. Christmas snowstorm had blanketed a wide patch of rural eastern Pennsylvania, and Chris Clark Davidson probably should have waited until the roads were plowed before she, her mother, and her two small sons attempted to drive. But Chris's grandmother lived alone more than 100 miles away and couldn't get out to buy groceries. "We'll be fine," Chris reassured her mother. "We'll take the shortcut we use all summer." They found the shortcut, turned onto it. Chris had forgotten how narrow the road was, especially with drifts piled high and wide, blowing snow across the fields. Usually chatting on previous drives, neither woman had noticed how deserted the area was. When another vehicle roared around a curve, Chris swerved and skidded into a snowbank. The other car kept going. The wheels spun uselessly as she tried to pull out. "Mommy, are we stuck?" Philip, her toddler, asked from under his blanket in the back seat. "Looks that way, honey," Chris admitted. They had only seen that one car since they turned into the shortcut. How long would it be before someone came along? How long before the freezing temperature invaded the car's interior? And why, oh why, had she worn sandals and pantyhose instead of warm boots? Chris got out, her feet plunging into a high snowdrift, and she looked around. "Lord, please send us some help." Then she saw it, a silo and barn roof peeking up from the hills about a quarter mile away. "Mom," Chris leaned in the car, "I'll walk down to that barn, see if anyone's there. Keep the kids warm." The journey was incredibly cold, and by the time Chris pushed open the barn door, her feet icy. A welcome blast of heat greeted her, along with the mooing of heifers in their stalls. It was a working dairy, clean and well organized, with a shiny window fan circulating the air. Even better, Chris heard young male voices behind a stall, maneuvering around fresh manure. She followed the sound and came upon two farmhands in overalls and flannel shirts, kidding and teasing each other. They stopped and smiled when they saw her, and she quickly explained the situation. "Stay here," one said, traipsing past the cows and out the door. A few moments later, Chris heard a horn honking from in front of the barn. There he was, driving a blue pickup truck. "Get in," he shouted. Chris hesitated. She didn't know these men, and yet there was something so merry about them that she couldn't feel afraid. She and the other farmhand and scrambled into the pickup, bounced down the road. There was the car, her toddlers bundled up, Mom waving. The driver roared across a field, spun in a wide circle, and screeched to position in front of it. "Way to go," his buddy yelled. Chris gripped the seat. "Do you always drive like this?" she asked, somewhat half joking. The driver shrugged. "Well, it ain't our truck." Within minutes, the men had freed Chris's car. She opened her purse to reward them. But both backed away. "It was our pleasure, ma'am. Just
drive safe. You may not like you, Chris thought to herself, grinning as she pulled away. What wonderful guys. Chris didn't realize just how wonderful until 2 weeks later when she and her mother decided to make a return visit to her grandmother. Since the snow was almost melted now and the shortcut was safer, soon the silo and barn roof came into view. Let's stop and let the guys know we made it to Grandma's house that day, Chris suggested. But when they pulled up, with paint peeling and door hinges hanging loose, bewildered, Chris wiped away a heavy film of dirt and cobwebs in the milk house window and peered inside. Where were the heifers? Where were the floors? Littered with fresh manure. Even the fan was rusty. You couldn't have seen any when she went to inquire. No one's worked that property for years. Chris got in the car. Am I crazy, Mom? She asked. No. Her mother was firm. This is definitely the place. Then how? Suddenly, Chris understood. I like the shepherds at that first Christmas. She was filled with awe. Her angels had worn blue jeans instead of white robes, but they had delivered the same timeless message to her and to anyone willing to listen.